Hello students, a very warm welcome to all of you on the platform of an academy. I hope everybody is doing great. In today's session, we are going to start with chapter number 6 of the high book, that is My Childhood, which is a part of Wings of Fire, the autobiography written by APJ Abdul Kalam. We'll read the story, we'll analyze the chapter, we'll take a look at how Abdul Kalam led his childhood and what all struggles he had to go through. We read all of that. But before that, let me quickly talk about an academy subscription, which will give you access to multiple courses out there, and it will also give you, not many educators for you who you can choose from. And yes, there are top educators on the platform. I'll talk about the an academy subscription and what all features it entails. But before that, let me quickly tell you, you must also remember the code, that is Romana10. This is my code, and if you use the code while taking the subscription, you can also get 10% flat off. Okay, so do not forget that. And that also brings me to the point that my name is Romana, and for those students who do not know me, let me quickly introduce myself to you. I have completed my master's from Delhi University, and I have been tutoring for a while now. I have been a part of the education sector for a while now. It's been more than 7 years. Okay, now to start with the chapter, students, let me quickly take you through the chapter and tell you that what does the story talk about. So basically, this story narrates the early days of Abdul Kalam and how his childhood was not very different from our childhood. So he also had to go through the same struggle, same life, or maybe similar, not same, but similar to a great extent. Like, he also had his own hardship. So aisa hame nahi sochna chahiye ki agar koi scientist hai, wo hamare 11th president bhi reh chuke hain, और उन्हें पीपल्स प्रेसिडेंट बोला जाता था. ये सब चीजें आपको पता होनी चाहिए. दैट ही वाज द 11th प्रेसिडेंट, राइट? एंड ही वाज आल्सो कॉल्ड पीपल्स प्रेसिडेंट बिकॉज़ ही वाज लव्ड बाय पीपल. ओके, ही लव्ड चिल्ड्रन इमेंसली. इग्नाइटेड माइंड्स, इट्स एन नॉट एम. ओके, सो इग्नाइटेड माइंड्स इज वन ऑफ द books that he has written, which is full of inspiration, full of motivation. So Ignited Minds is one written for students, children, and he is the one person who believes that students are the future of the country. Okay, at the same time, he's also called Missile Man of India. You all should know that. Okay, all right, we should know all of these things about him. But then, of course, this was the ultimate thing about him that we all know, what he became, how he transformed. He did a lot of research, and he actually gave India a lot of contribution in the field of science and research. We all know that, but the question over here is, was his journey any different? How was his childhood? Full of bed of roses? Not at all. He also had his share of struggle, and we'll get to know what all he had to go through. Okay, now of course this story takes us to Kalam's journey, his struggle as a child, and how he became a successful scientist and the president of India in future. Okay, let's start with chapter summary, where we get to know that he came from a middle class Tamil family in the town of Rameshwaram, which is in Madras, and his father Jainulabdin did not receive much of formal education, that's true, but he had innate wisdom, a lot of wisdom in him, and he was a true generous person. So he has a lot of generosity. What is generosity? Of helpful nature, kind nature. Okay, quite helpful. Now, he lived an austere and simple life. What is austere? Very strict. Okay, strict life. So it's not that he led a life which was full of freedom. No, his father was quite austere. He followed discipline, decorum, a lot of strictness in his childhood. He avoided all inessential comforts and luxury. So who are we talking about? His father. And Kalam's mother, Ashiyamma, fed so many people in a day that he couldn't recall the exact number. And she was also a generous lady. She also fed people. Whosoever came to the house was fed. Okay, and the qualities of self-discipline, generosity, honesty were driven from his parents. Okay, so these were all derived from his parents. So his parents were kind, they were generous, they were giving, they were disciplined. Okay, and of course this was passed on to APJ Abdul Kalam as well. Now let's talk about the current situation of the country, as in the current situation in the country. So this was a time period of Second World War has broke out in the country in 1939, and during that period he was just 8 years old, and then India was forced to join Allied forces. Because of that, there were several changes that were happening in the country simultaneously, and there was his cousin who did the job of distributing newspapers. And what happened then, that there was one notification according to which the trains were suspended. So ye jo trains jo thi jo Rameshwaram station pe ruka karti thi, ab wo nahi rukti thi. Is wajah se kya hua, jo Samsuddin the, jo inki cousin se, he required a helping hand. He needed somebody to help him for the distribution of newspapers. So who got the chance? It was of course APJ Abdul Kalam, who became the helping hand, and he took the spot. Okay, now of course, why? Because now he had to throw newspapers very fast. Okay, now there is another incident that we get to know, which we'll talk about, that happened in grade 5 when he was in standard 5th. And a new teacher came to the class of Kalam. We'll talk about him. But let me quickly tell you that Kalam had three friends, Ramananda Shastri, then Aravindan and Shiva Prakashan. Okay. So you read about these three in this particular chapter. And in the class, what happened, that there was this incident where Abdul Kalam was wearing a hat like this little boy, you can see. So Muslims usually wear this cap, okay? And this was kind of a distinct feature that could help anybody to recognize that, oh, he's a Muslim, all right? So he sat with his best friend. You all know that his best friend was Ramananda, who came from a family of priests. His father was a priest, so he did not mind, of course, but he wore a sacred thread, so it suggests that he came from a Brahmin family, a priest family, right? But then what happened then was that they sat together, they always sat together in the class, but this man came to the class who could not stand this view. He could not digest this fact that APJ Abdul Kalam, a Muslim boy, is sitting with a Hindu upper caste Brahmin, and he could not really he was not able to seep in. Okay, he could not just really digest that fact. But then what am I saying, a Muslim boy sitting with a Hindu? Okay, so what did he do? He quickly asked him to go and sit at the back bench. Go to the back bench, that is what he said. Okay, so he asked Kalam to sit on the back bench, and of course these children, they were kind of sobbing. They had a very bad feeling at that point in time. They could not take this in. They could not because for children, they do not care about religion, and of course not even adult children care much. I mean, I personally feel it's a spiritual thing, but here of course this was a set of bearing. This teacher was not secular in his views, in his mindset. So what did he do? He distinguished and he asked him to go and sit at the back. A behavior that should not be encouraged in school setup at all. Okay, so then what happened then was that he of course got his share of punishment. These two children, because they were best friends, they went back home and they complained this to their parents, and their parents came and complained to the principal. And of course, after the report, the Lakshmana Shastri summoned the teacher. So this was probably the principal. He called the teacher and told him not to spread poison of social inequality and communal intolerance. Okay, so ye do important words hain, inpe questions bhi aa sakte hain, in the minds of innocent children. To unhone kaha ki bachchon ke dimag mein aap ye hatred mat phailaiye, aap teacher hain, aap unhe harmony aur peacemaking sikhaiye. He was asked to either apologize or quit the school. Not only did the teacher regret his behavior, but the strong sense of conviction Lakshman Shastri conveyed ultimately reformed this young teacher. Aur aisa nahi hai kisi ko ne afsos hua apne is behavior pe, unhe baad mein ek ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन भी आया, उन्हें रियलाइज हुआ कि ये बच्चे आपस में कितने वेल बॉन्डेड हैं और ये सारी चीजें हमें नहीं करनी चाहिए. ओके सो ही इट्स काइंड ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड. अच्छा इसको बता दो ये कौन है, ये देख के क्या लग रहा है कौन हो सकती है ये. सो शी इज समवन, शी इज द कंजर्वेटिव वाइफ ऑफ द टीचर. ओके ओके आई एम सो सॉरी दैट आई हैव गॉट दिस इमेज ओवर हियर, बट दिस इज जस्ट फॉर यू नो सेटिंग अप अ मूड एंड मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड एंड रिमेंबर द कैरेक्टर वेल. ये है शिव सुब्रमण्या अय्यर, उनकी वाइफ का एक आप कह सकते हो जस्ट अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन, नॉट हर, बट ऑफ कोर्स व्हाई दिस इमोजी है और व्हाई दिस एक्सप्रेशन हुआ है, बिकॉज शी वाज अ बिट शॉक्ड, है ना, कि वो कहे कि अरे what happened. okay let's quickly go back to the incident. so one occasion a science teacher of Abdul Kalam invited him for dinner. of course we should write Abdul Kalam, but because it's his childhood so in Abdul Kalam bolkar nahi Abdul bolkar bhi kai bar refer kiya gaya hai, because for the teacher he was Abdul, and invited him for dinner. the conservative wife of the teacher refused to serve Kalam. okay but this wife she was not happy with the sight at all. So she decided not to serve him. Okay. But then the teacher decided that, okay, no problem. You don't serve him. I'll go sit by his side. I will feed him. I will serve him food. And he served him food because he was a guest there. And he sat next to him, ate with him. This incident kind of moved the woman as well, wife of the teacher as well. And she was observing all of this behind the door. And she saw that, okay, he's just a child. And also, this is not good behavior. I shouldn't behave like this. The science teacher gave a second invitation at the very moment. So he did not hesitate asking him for a second time and for a meal next week. He was hesitant. He didn't want to come because he has obviously observed what just happened. So now what happened? That. But then he came. Who came? Abdul Kalam came. And but then this time this wife was again transformed, and what did I say again, because there was another transformation in the story earlier, the teacher transformed, and now this time the wife has gone through a transformation and she served with both her hands to the child and the whole country. Okay, now then afterwards, okay, so this was the second incident. Now after the Second World War, India's freedom was imminent, matlab something that is certainly going to happen, certain to happen. Okay, ठीक है, तो पता था कि पक्का पक्का आजादी मिलने वाली है. एंड ऑफ कोर्स देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ होप ऑप्टिमिज्म इन द कंट्री. कलाम डिसाइडेड टू सीक हिज फादर्स परमिशन टू लीव रामेश्वरम एंड स्टडी एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट हेडक्वार्टर्स इन रामनाथपुरम. तो कलाम ने क्या डिसाइड किया कि अब वो अपनी आगे की पढ़ाई करेंगे और यहाँ से बाहर जाएंगे. ठीक है, तो उन्हें परमिशन लेनी थी ऑफकोर्स. तो उनके फादर ने कुछ बहुत बेहतरीन उनके साथ शेयर किया, जो खलील गिब्रान की कुछ बातें हैं जो उन्होंने उनके साथ शेयर करी. ओके, हिज फादर टोल्ड हिम, सो आई हैव कोटेड दिस एंटायर एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम योर बुक एनसीईआरटी, ओके, बिकॉज इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई थिंक क्वेश्चंस कैन कम फ्रॉम हियर. अबुल, सो ही कॉल्ड हिम इन अ लव्ड मैनर. ओके, अबुल, आई नो यू हैव टू गो अवे टू ग्रो. डज द सीगल नॉट फ्लाई अक्रॉस द सन अलोन विदाउट अ नेस्ट? He quoted, okay, and let me tell you here that he's speaking as if he's thinking. At the same time, what is his motive here? He wants to reinstate this or give this message to his mother that I know you are very much attached to the child, but you should remember that you have to let him go. If you want your child to fly, if you want to give wings to your child, you will have to let him go. You will have to allow him to experience his own journey. Okay, so he is saying as if he's talking to himself. Okay, let's see how this happens. His father told him, Abul, I know you have to go away to grow. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? Okay, and then he quoted Khalil Gibran to his hesitant mother, of course, your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. This is very deep. You will have to understand. You will have to pause and then think about it and then reread it to understand it. They come through you, but not from you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts. फॉर दे हैव देयर ओन थॉट्स। तो वो क्या कहते हैं, इसको थोड़ा ध्यान से समझते हैं। वो बेसिकली उनकी जो माँ है वो थोड़ा हेजिटेंट है, वो अपने बच्चे को बाहर नहीं जाने देना चाहती हैं। तो उनके फादर एक तरह से कहते हैं कि क्या कहा है कि आपका जो अगर सीगल है वो डिसाइड करे कि मैं अपने बच्चे को उड़ने नहीं दूंगा तो क्या वो कभी फ्लाई कर पाएगा? अगर वो अपने कुकून से अपने नेस्ट से बाहर ना निकले तो क्या कभी वो उड़ना सीख पाएगा? नहीं सीख पाएगा। इसी तरह से आपके बच्चे तो हैं, आपके थ्रू तो आते हैं लेकिन वो आपको बिलोंग उस हद तक नहीं करते। उनकी अपनी एक जिंदगी है, ऐसा तो नहीं है कि ऊपर वाले ने जब बच्चे आए दुनिया में तो उन्हें आपका ही पेरेंट्स का ही थॉट प्रोसेस दे दिया कि जो पेरेंट्स सोचेंगे वही हम सोचेंगे, जो वो करेंगे वही हम करेंगे। ऐसा नहीं है। ऑफकोर्स पेरेंट्स की जो फिलोसफी होती है, उनका जो उनकी जो अपब्रिंगिंग होती है वो बच्चों में कई हद तक रिफ्लेक्ट करती है, लेकिन बच्चों को अपना दिमाग भी दिया गया है, उनको भी एक थॉट प्रोसेस दिया गया है, तो बच्चे खुद से भी सोचने के काबिल हैं, सोच सकते हैं। ठीक है, तो यू मे गिव देम लव, यू मे गिव देम योर लव बट नॉट योर थॉट्स। तुम अपनी सोच उन पे इम्पोज नहीं कर सकते हो, फॉर दे हैव देयर ओन थॉट्स। तो वो अपने हिसाब से सोचेंगे और अपनी जिंदगी खुद से एक्सप्लोर करेंगे। ठीक है, क्लियर है। और इसी के साथ हमें पता चलता है कि इसके बाद उनकी जर्नी शुरू हुई, उन्होंने पढ़ाई करी और किस तरह से फाइनली फिर हमें पता है कि वो हमारे प्रेसिडेंट बने और इतने बड़े मिसाइल मैन भी बने और काफी कुछ किया उन्होंने कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट साइंस और टेक्नोलॉजी के फील्ड में। ठीक है, अभी कुछ क्वेश्चन है, वी हैव अ लुक एट इट क्विकली। दीज आर डू इट योर सेल्फ क्वेश्चन, जस्ट अ लुक फॉर यू। ओके, यू कैन हैव अ लुक, ग्लैंस इट एंड राइट आंसर्स फॉर दीज। यू मे ऑल्सो गेट MCQs फॉर टर्म वन, सो प्रिपेयर वेल। वॉट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स डज ही से ही इनहेरिटेड फ्रॉम हिज पेरेंट्स? सो वी आर रेफरिंग टू अब्दुल कलाम, राइट? दैट वॉट ऑल डिड ही इनहेरिट फ्रॉम हिज पेरेंट्स? ऑफकोर्स वी ऑल नो जेनरोसिटी, यस, ही सेड ही inherited generosity from them, yes, and of course from his mother and father, wisdom also, I think a lot of wisdom. Okay, so this answer I've already given you. Why did Abdul Kalam want to leave Rameshwaram? Of course to pursue his further studies. Please do this on your own, please complete these questions. Your children are not your children, they are the sons and daughters of life's longing for itself. What does the statement reflect about the beliefs of Kalam's father? Of course we believe that he's a man of lot of motivation and a man of willpower person, a person who has strong willpower and courage, and he was determined to let him go, he wanted him to go, and he was supportive, very supportive. Okay, so ye aap thoda sa soch kar apne hisab se read kijiye aur jo cheeze aapne padhi aaj ki class mein uske basis pe ise answer kijiye. Every child is born with some inherited characteristics into a specific socioeconomic and emotional environment. What did Kalam inherit from? Of course, same question but in a different manner. So MCQ ke format mein bhi ye question aa sakta hai. Bahut dhyan se padhiyega. Enumerate a few examples that suggest that Kalam's family had a secular outlook. Ab kuch aise examples aapki book mein diye hain jahan pe hame pata chalta hai ki ye bahut hi secular the. Inke parents wo feed karte the logo ko aur koi discrimination nahi karte the. Theek hai, to iske upar bhi do teen incidents aise aur jo aap dekh sakte ho. And of course ye log friends the aapas mein, बच्चे, तो ऑफ कोर्स दे नेवर हेजिटेटेड, दे नेवर मेड एनी काइंड ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ओवर देयर। तो ये भी आप नरेट यहाँ पे कर सकते हो। चलिए ठीक है, दैट ब्रिंग्स अस टू टॉक अबाउट द अनअकैडमी सब्सक्रिप्शन हियर व्हिच आई एम श्योर यू मस्ट ऑल बी वांटिंग टू टेक, आई एम श्योर आफ्टर द सेशन। एंड यू ऑल शुड नो दैट अनअकैडमी प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन गिव्स यू अ लॉट मोर अपॉर्चुनिटी टू इंटरैक्ट with educators, because we also have several new features there. At the same time, students, you must know that you get access to all the courses and you have top educators on the platform. We have regular doubt clearing, answer writing sessions on the platform. Then you also have the exhaustive coverage. You also get to cover the entire syllabus. So jo bhi exam aap choose karte hain apni profile mein, us exam ki puri puri taiyari Unacademy aapko karati hai. So of course you crack it with Unacademy if you take the plus subscription. Saath saath bachcho, mentorship bhi milegi, guidance bhi milega us exam ke liye. Study material PDF format mein aapko milega, practice test, live test, aur course ko batches mein divide kiya jayega. Iske beyond aapko daily practice session bhi milenge. Okay, और आपके पास वीकली मॉक टेस्ट सीरीज भी है, लाइव क्विजेस भी है, एमसीक्यू भी है, ये सब कुछ भी आपको साथ साथ मिलता है। इसकी प्राइसिंग बहुत कम हो चुकी है, ठीक है, अभी इस पे और भी डिस्काउंट्स चलते रहते हैं बच्चों, तो आप ध्यान से देख लीजिएगा जो प्राइसिंग है 48 मंथ्स की, इसमें भी डिस्काउंट्स होते हैं। ये 3 मंथ से लेकर के आपके पास 48 मंथ्स तक का सब्सक्रिप्शन अवेलेबल है, आप जो भी चाहें वो आप चूज कर सकते हैं अपने लिए। प्लस में ऑफकोर्स इस पे आपको 10% डिस्काउंट मिलेगा अगर आप ये कोड यूज करेंगे Romana10। ऑलराइट, बट आई वुड रीइंस्टेट, आई विल टेल यू वन मोर टाइम दैट दिस प्राइस इज ऑलवेज रिवाइज्ड और इस पे कुछ ना कुछ डिस्काउंट चलता रहता है हमेशा। तो आप एकदम यू नो लेटेस्ट डिस्काउंट है वो लेने के लिए, एक तो सबसे पहले आप ये कोड यूज कर लेंगे ताकि आपको इमीडिएटली 10% ऑफ मिल जाए, ठीक है। और ऑफकोर्स इफ यू टेक द सब्सक्रिप्शन फॉर अ लॉन्गर ड्यूरेशन आपको मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट मिलता है, तो अगर आप 48 मंथ्स का सब्सक्रिप्शन लेंगे तो आपको सबसे ज्यादा डिस्काउंट मिलेगा। ओके, नाउ ऑफकोर्स अनअकैडमी आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन क्या है, ये एक अलग सब्सक्रिप्शन है जिसमें आपको 1-on-1 मेंटोरशिप मिलती है, पर्सनल मेंटोर होते हैं आपके, लाइव डाउट सोल्यूशन होता है, वीकली रिपोर्ट कार्ड मिलता है, पेरेंट्स कनेक्ट है, स्टडी प्लानर है, और ये सारा कुछ आपको अनअकैडमी के सब्सक्रिप्शन के साथ जो बाकी फीचर्स है इसके टॉप एजुकेटर और ये सब भी मिलता है, ठीक है। नाउ लेट मी टेक यू थ्रू द प्राइसिंग ऑफ आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन विच ऑल्सो स्टार्ट्स विद 3 मंथ्स और ये कहाँ तक जाता है, आपके पास 48 मंथ्स तक का सब्सक्रिप्शन है और ये सबसे जुडिशियस होता है, सबसे ज्यादा अकलमंदी इसी में है कि आप 48 मंथ्स का सब्सक्रिप्शन ले या 36 मंथ्स का लें जो आपको मैक्सिमम डिस्काउंट देगा। अब आपके पास ईएमआई और पार्ट्स में पे करने का भी ऑप्शन है, तो ईएमआई पे ये सारा कुछ और भी कम प्राइसिंग हो जाती है, ठीक है। और ये मेरा कोड है जिसे आप यूज करेंगे तो 10% डिस्काउंट तो बिल्कुल आपको साथ साथ मिल जाएगा। ओके, एंड आई रियली होप दैट यू ऑल आर क्रैकिंग इट विद अनअकैडमी, यू आर हैविंग अ वंडरफुल टाइम। डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू लाइक द वीडियो इफ यू एंजॉयड द सेशन एंड शेयर इट विद ऑल योर फ्रेंड्स हु आर इन 9th ग्रेड, एंड इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल प्लीज डू इट। ओके, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग, टेक केयर एवरीवन, बाय बाय।